Hello, everyone, and welcome to race number 9 of the season here in the Season 6 NRSL Outback Xfinity Series here at Papyrus Motorsports Park. This is another road course that we're going to have in our season, our third. Hard to believe we're having this many, or actually, excuse me, it's our fourth road course. My apologies. So, Austin Mongold is on the pole for today's race. We'll leave our ticker up there. Second is John Art, 3rd, Chris Dawson, 4th, Benjamin Miles, 5th, James Squall, 6th, Ramey Fisher, 17th, Sanford, 8th, RJ Bishop, 9th, Kyle Keith, clean the top 10 is Sam Curtis. Give us your starting line from 11th on back. On the front row, we have Andres Baranskas and Noah Punter. So as you can see on our board, we have 16 laps that's coming around for today's race. Looking at our points after 8 races, Paul Barber is the points leader. Jeffrey Fingai is second. Jessica Shelton fell back a few spots. She's now in the third. Dylan Thoreau is up to fourth with that win. Kyle Keith is fifth. Sam Curtis sixth. Austin Mongold jumped up to seventh. Ryan Acosta is 8th, Brett Pritchard gained 3 spots in 9th, and still in 10th place in points, Angel Navarro, Kyle Matthews, just a little bit short with Nick Johnson, 32 points each in 11th and 12th. That'd be your top 10 if the chase were to start after that race. So we got about another 20 seconds, and to see where our previous race winner Dylan Thoreau is, there's the 62 all the way in the 40th position. He's going to have a lot of ground to make up. And we're about ready to get the command to fire him up here at Pirates.
Drivers, start your engines.
There's the command to fire him up. So we're going to take you to the green in just a minute. We're going to let the cars roll on up. Then we're going to take you to the green flag action here at Papyrus. As you're watching it on Fox Sports 1 here on the NRSL. So as you can see, Austin Mongold with the pole for today's race. Mongold's had a really good consistent season with the starting. However, the finishing, he's got to make sure he really steps up. He almost won it at Open Roads last race. We'll see if he wins here at Papyrus. So without further ado, the pace car going down pit road just earlier. 16 laps of action. We are Green Flag Racing here at Papyrus. Rewind battle you see behind the 70 of Qualls and the 18 of Ramey Fisher. There's actually one car in the wall. That's Sam Curtis scraping the wall there, and he's going to keep it off. Both the races we had at Open Roads were probably finish of the year because of how well they were as they enter the right-hander here. We'll see if this road course turns really well. Is there 3 wide for position here? That's not a good idea into this corner here. It's the outside line. Inside, rather. Keith actually tapped the wall, but he'll be all right. And we may have encountered trouble, and we did. Caution is out. Trouble for Dylan Thoreau, Andres Baranskas, Jonathan Zorlin, Matt Dixon, Chris Todd, Carson Dumb, Brett Pritchard, Cole Deaver, and Brian James again. Wow, James just no luck this season. His return to NR. Coming to the line, however, Austin Mongold will lead them down. Dixon, also another person that's been struggling this season, dead last in points. That's making that indication to come down pit road. No one else is, however. A lot of damage, though, to the 44 of Jonathan Zorlin. And I believe, yes, Baranskas and Thoreau may have gotten stuck on the apron. So if they can get out ahead of the leaders, they'll be okay. There's Matt Dixon in the 48. For second, Keith. Dead last of the points with a really not good season at all. He's just been starting poor and finishing poor. And just like that, he's already out of it. probably fix that. Oh, we had a stack up. And problems for Dodd, Johnson, Shelton, Flickinger, Beaver, Gardner. Carson Gum may have avoided it. Brian James, Kyle Matthews, and also the 16 of Paul Minnick. I think they stacked up because they lost place where they were in line, and that created a huge pileup. So caution's out for the first time today. Mungles, let's go take a look what caught out the caution, and then we'll check out the pileup. You're going to see right here, Brett Pritchard kind of gets a bounce off the six going into the corner, goes into Kev Sheeran, and the car's going to slide right in front of Jonathan Zerlin and Carson Gum. They have nowhere to go. Batson's trying to slide. Gum and Deaver go into each other. Cicoli barely avoids the crash there. And Matt Dixon, Brian James pile up. Mick's going to get involved. Gardner, Baronskas, Dodd, you're going to see Nick Johnson, Dylan Throw. It's a light bump. Throw and the two of Baronskas actually go in the apron, get stuck. Noah Ponser also getting lightly involved. So that's what happened with those guys that got involved in that crash. However, we had a pileup, and we're going to go to Paul Minnick. I think it's going to start with that area. Yep, yeah, I figured because, let's see. I don't know what 14th on back were doing. They were just bunched up. They were in the correct position, you could see. But these guys that were trying to catch up, they were just going way too fast. You could tell they were. And what's going to happen, Paul Minnick, you can tell, that's like a 30-mile-per-hour difference. Minnick just trying to slow down and trying to use the correct line and not, like, get plowed into, unfortunately. Your boy, Seth Cole, he's tapped by the 54. And there's the 5, the 20, 22, 19, and others just going to pile on in. That was just a bad case of a plow and not paying attention by these drivers. However, I think the 5 car, despite getting the damage, I think avoided the worst end of it. Same for the 54. Then here comes more guys coming on in. Noah Ponser, Nick Johnson, Carson Gum, Chris Dodd. Dodd goes into Nick Johnson, rather. That added insult to injury. I'm Matthew. Sam Curtis got away with that. It's very luckily very minimal damage. So that's a look. Brower sells our first caution and the pileup involved there. Caution's out. Mongol's the leader. Let's go take it back to the green. Lights on top of the pace car out, which gives us the one to go. Drivers out of the race include the following. Matt Dixon, Jonathan Zerlin. They were from the initial caution. And then from the pileup were Dodd, Deaver, James, Flickinger, Gardner. Baronskas and Thoreau did not get out in time, so they are a lap down. However, they have a good possibility of getting back on the lead lap because this is their only chance. And then Brett Pritchard originally was 32nd, but then he came down pit road, and he is still on pit road. I guess they're repairing the damage on the 43 a little bit more, but they're trying to get him out ahead of time. It does not look like it. Top 10 rundown includes the following: Austin Mongold, Benjamin Miles, John Art, Angel Navarro, as I'm tongue-twisting badly there, Chris Dollerton, Ramian Fisher, James Qualls, Kyle Keith, Kev Shear, and Zachary Fitzwater. Top 10. Top 15 is RJ Bishop, Paul Barber, Gene Sanford, Grace Ace Vado, Jeffrey Fingai, Connor Meyer, Josh Scully, Joshua Osborne, Wayne Carson. Clean the top 20 is Henry Sanford. Now you see from Paul Minnick on back, which is 26th on back, they have damage from the pileup. Green flag about to be underway. Brett Pritchard will not get out in time, as you can see. Mongold will take the green. Now you can tell the 62 and the 2 are not damaged. They did receive a little bit, but it's not enough to get them off the pace. And already, smart move by the 25 there of Ange Navarro. Going to go to the inside line and follow the 2 and 62. Dylan Thoreau. Now back in the lead lap, Andres Baronskas trying to follow. Smart move by the 62 to move to that right side of the line, trying to make sure that 51 doesn't try to go underneath. The two car will remain a lap down. However, Dylan Thoreau in good hands. Looking to run by the two of Baransk is trying to get back on the lead lap with the hard push there. Avoid hitting the wall. And did anybody have any trouble? Nope. We are still good. Trouble, though, for 55 of PJ Williams. Hit the wall. We're good. Look at Jeffrey Fingai in the run. I think his 81 may have hit the wall there. Or there, he slipped, and Brett Pritchard just got back out on the track. Now Baranskas is getting shuffled around. Allerton got around the two. Now John Art wants to get around the lap machine of Andres Baranskas. Mongold is still the leader. Benjamin Miles second, and Chris Allerton is third. A good run for the party, making his comeback in the NRSL and in NR as well. Look at this battle right here. That's Kev Shear, Angel Navarro, RJ Bishop, and Zachary Fitzwater. All within the top 10. Nice run by Shear right there. Got a whale of a run. Navarro, that or Navarro just totally slipped there because he really did not get going there. And now he is freight training there. I think he may have slipped the gear there. And now Benjamin Miles. James Walls now taking the lead, but now Miles, I think, will get it off the turn. Never mind James Walls with the run. And Walls is going to hold on. Ross, as you can see, it's getting shuffled around. From what I see, that's about in the top 10, because that's Gene Sanford's in ninth, I believe that is. Oh, Kyle Keefe nearly just got turned by RJ Bishop. Keeps it together, though. But Dylan Thoreau, he got out just in time, got ahead of all the leaders, and he's in good hands. There you see the slow car of Brett Pritchard. Definitely not happy. He's a lap down. Alfred second. That's Edward Miles and Austin Mongold. Thoreau now under fire from James Walls for the lap down column. He will do so. Nice run by the 51, but a better run by John Art. Look at him go in the 42. And Chris Allerton as well. That's her second. And that two. Whoa, Shear got a run the 18, almost got ran over. That two car is slipping back. Like I mentioned, the 62, the two really doesn't have damage. It's just getting shuffled around. However, it's getting treated as if it is. That's a tough blow for Andres Baranskas. And remember, the caution comes out. Baranskas won't get that opportunity to be back on the front end trying to get that lap back. And one chance, and that's it in this track. And unfortunately, it's come and gone. The same can be said for Dylan Thoreau. He's got to get around James Qualls before another caution comes out, if it does. Baranskas is getting shuffled around, though. Angel Navarro actually having a little bit of trouble trying to get around the two. I guess the two is really damaged in some type of way because, well, they're actually up to speed with Ace Rogers and Joshua Osborne. Just, I'm not sure if that two is just having a small problem or just dropping the back on purpose. There you see some of the guys that got involved there. Sam Curtis, very luckily, still in 29th. A little bit damaged. He's got Paul Minnick still ahead of him somehow. Then you got Matthews, Gum, Shelton, all behind. Same for Pritchard, who could get caught by James Qualls if we stay green. And now Thoreau getting passed by Art and Dollerton. Gene Sanford was going to get that opportunity. Now he's going to have to wait. Thoreau trying to come back here in the 62. But right now the top three are ahead of the 62, South Point Chevrolet of Dylan Thoreau. Paul Barber just got around RJ Bishop at the top 10 spot right there. Will do so. Trying to at least complete the pass. Can't seem to do it. Mongold slipped back ever since he lost the lead. He's still in the top 10. Same for Benjamin Miles. He's hanging in there. Looks like a battle for 11th, it looks like. Could be between Kyle Keat and Zachary Fitzwater. And now Kev Shear want to add on into that. A three-wide battle. Trying to get that run, that inside line. Just not going to do it. And excuse me, that was for 10th rather, not for 11th. Fitzwater still trying to get the run. It's Uncle Bob Storage Chevrolet. And we'll get that pass there. And on Benjamin Miles. Nice run by the 39 right there. And now Thoreau, he ain't quitting yet. He wants his lap back. I think from the way it goes, though, he's pretty much SOL, so basically going to be an extra car in the way there. Trying to pressure, though, James Qualls and John Art now at the lead. Sega Keith looking for their second win in the Xfinity Series. Have not yet won in the Cup Series. Al Keith won at Auto Club earlier this season. Now John Art trying to be the first rookie of the team to do it. First newcomer. No one else has won yet for Sega Keith in the Outback Xfinity Series. Keith has won now two for the team. One in the 42 and now one in the 24. Chris Dollerton now to the lead. But now look at Dylan Thoreau going three wide trying to get his lap back. Not going to work. Oh, James Qualls and Gene Sanford. That was some close racing. They nearly keep it together from going into each other. That's going to allow Dollerton to run away. Stays green, they may approach that slower lap machine. Check with the two. Yeah, that Duke car really slipping back. Has to deal with Seth Cole and Joshua Osborne. Oh, Wayne Carson just got in the wall. Lost a spot to Fitzwater, Henry Stamper, and Grayson Acevedo. He's trying to hold on that spot to Acevedo and will do so. Go on board with one driver right here. Let's go on board with the number 33 of Benjamin Miles. And he's on a Hornet's Nest right now, so we're definitely going on board with the 33 once we cross the stripe and show you the view of Papyrus Motorsports Park coming off the exit of the turn to complete a lap. You can see the Ream onboard Chevrolet right there. You know, it's a Hornet's Nest with a pack right now. It's Ace Rogers, Paul Barber, and Kyle Keith on that inside line in front of him. That's Kev Shearer and Gene Sanford, those two blue cars there. And you can see a battle for the lead there between John Art and Chris Dollerson taking place. And Art will get that faster there. But you can see, it's not a wide track, but it's not a slim track. It's kind of in the middle. If you can do two wide, if you can do three wide, but you can't really do four wide, that would not be the best idea. About this road course here. It's a big right-hander here. Vertical tracks in the NR is made, and Barber's got the ball right there. A lot of elevational changes, too, on this track, where you see a lot of downhill and uphill, especially with the banking as well. And a lot of flat. Like, you get that mixed pattern of how that racing is. Right here, this is the final two turns come into play here. Very simple bank here. And then you head towards the start finish line and dash trying to get over there, and that is a lap around Papyrus Motorsports Park. So as we have a total of four laps to go, and you always question to wonder if that lap traffic is going to be the same. Don't throw again trying to go three wide for in his lap pack. He really wants to finish this race on the lead lap. This time he gets a run on that inside line, and will complete the pass. Bishop, though, will get the lead from Chris Dollerton. There's Pritchard. He just exited the right-hander. They are catching him. Rowe is hoping, though, that if they encounter that 43, he can somehow get away from him first, so that way the leaders have some trouble. 18 nearly just got the wall right there, that Aris Toyota there. Finn guy just got the wall, and Fitzwater got held up. Winner at Hogzilla right there. Now Fitzwater and Ace Vado trying to get around Finn Guy using the high line. Look at Ace Vado looking the extreme high line there. That's your, look at your winners at Ireland and Hogzilla for Ace Vado and Fitzwater. And now they're going to keep together there. Three wide there. That was Mongol, Ace Rogers, and Gene Sanford. They're going to keep it together, though. Sanford, the rookie of the family here. Three wide between the lap car and the two that are bound to the lead. That's Chris Dollerton and John Art. And there is Brett Pritchard. They are not too far away from him. Art Bishop and Dollarton and Ramey and Fisher will all get around the 62 before the right-hander. You can see the 43 just enter the right-hander. You can tell they are closing in. What's it going to be for these leaders when they encounter him? And who's going to really take the advantage? For John R., he hopes his teammate will not block him. And for Rowe, he's got to hope that everyone has some trouble to get around the 43 as the 62 just got the wall. It's not going to help Dylan Thoreau out one bit. However, he did slow down Benjamin Miles. He'll still get the run on the outside, and Qualls will use the inside to get around him. But here we go. They are closing in on him, and I guarantee you this lap, lap 15, they are going to get him. Qualls have struggled to get around the 62. Allison just got passed by Ramey Fisher and Benjamin Miles. Ramey Fisher's had a really good car in that 18. It's been a long time since Fisher has won, especially in the Xfinity Series. Last win came at Talladega, I believe, a couple seasons back when he drove the 43 car. 43 now being a part of second heat there. Bishop and John Art. Two really strong cars here. Bishop runs both Xfinity and the Cup Series. Art only runs in Xfinity for right now, but that may change next season. You never know. There's that 43. They are just catching him. Bro, despite hitting that wall, he really recovered well. He didn't have to worry about much. James Qualls, however, did get the wall a bit, and now Shelton trying to take the advantage. Ever since that one caution, we've had good, clean racing. Some good battling, though, with these drivers. Bronska's still falling back. Pritchard. I thought they were going to count him on this lap. It looks like Pritchard's still been able to hang in there very well. But you can see coming off this turn right here. See that camera angle, how that is. And that's about a 5, 6, 7, 8 second, 9 second differential between these guys. But the white flag's about to come out. Bound for the lead, coming to the line. Bishop, Art, and Fisher. White flag. 3 wide for the lead. Benjamin Miles in fourth. Chris Dollarton and Bitt, all 5 of the leaders, nose to tail, 5 and a piece, all into the turn, Thoreau. This innocent bystander of all this there. Bishop slides up the track. May have ended his chance for the win right there. Fisher trying to hope he does not encounter that 43. Art, Dollarton, Miles, trying to hunt down that 18 car. Art's got a good run and then an 18 right there. I don't know. They may not have to encounter that 43. They're laying off a bit so that way they don't have to encounter him there. Fisher trying to hold off John Art, though. Art got almost had a race one at Auxilla. He lost it on the last lap. He doesn't have to worry about Zachary Fitzwater this time. Now he's going to hunt down Ramey Fisher this time. Art trying to look for the lead. Here comes John Art for the lead. Oh, he can't do it. He was making a move. He couldn't do it, though. Brad Pritchard will not be involved. Ramey Fisher trying to hold off John Art and Benjamin Miles. That may have sealed it right there. Ramey Fisher is going to win at Papyrus. What a win for Ramey Fisher in car 18. Ramey Fisher, it's been a long time since we got to see him go in the victory lane here. If the memory serves me correctly, it may have been since season 4. In the Outback Xfinity Series, when he drove the 43, it was his first season for that car, and wouldn't you believe it, he moved over to the 18 this season. Originally, Caleb Harris drove that car, and now he just got himself his first win of the season and broke a big winless streak. Congratulations to Ramey Fisher. So let's see about your top 10 results here. Ramey Fisher ended up picking the win. John Ard second. Benjamin Miles third. RJ Bishop fourth. Gene Sanford fifth. Connor Myers sixth. James Qualls seventh. Chris Dollarton eighth. Ninth Kyle Keith. Winning top 10. Grayson Acevedo. Nice comeback for the 81 right there. There's the rest of your results here. 11th place. Ace Rogers there. He just fell back a bit there. Got some other nobles there. There's Henry. Zachary Fitzwater, 15th. Henry Sanford, 16th. Then guy 17th. Joshua Osborne completing the top 20. Wayne Carson, Connor Meyer, 21st, 22nd. Paul Mink was the first, Nick Johnson was the first of the cars that had damage. It was off the pace. He was 26th. When you go all the way down to the last car that finished on the lead lap, which was Carson Gumman, 31st. And then you got Jessica Shelton in 32nd. My bad, I meant to say Shelton there. Thoreau, 33rd, Baranskas, 34th, and Brett Pritchard finished in 35th. A lap down. That was the last car to finish the race. And as mentioned from before, Gardner, Flickinger, James, Deaver, Dodd, Zorlett, and Dixon all retired from the race. Well, thank you guys for watching. If you like this race, be sure to give a like, comment your thoughts, and subscribe part of the NRSL by hitting that subscribe button. And we will see you guys later for the Cup race here at Papyrus. Till then, goodbye, everybody, from Papyrus Motorsports Park.